Welcome, friends, to this Bhandara of my master, great master, Baba Sawan Singh Ji. This novel coronavirus has created a novel way for us to celebrate this Bhandara. We are going to celebrate this Bhandara online. We have never done that before. But in a way, there are some bright spots also. They say that every dark cloud has a silver lining. The silver lining here is that we can join together. I understand several thousand of you are watching me now. We can join together without having to buy plane tickets, without having to make reservations for hotels, without having to do all the hassle, without the fear of accidents on the road. So many things are a bright spot in this. And we are sitting at home and we are all celebrating this Bhandara together. Great Master Bhandara is a celebration of Bhandar. Bhandar means abundance. Abundance of what? Many people think is abundance of food. Sometimes we have Bhandara, people say food was good. But I am not talking of that Bhandar. We are celebrating the Bhandar of grace and blessings of Great Master. For some time back, people have been asking me, is a darshan on YouTube equal to a darshan in person? Do you feel that the master who is present on a live stream is as good as a master physically present? There are two ways of looking at it. If it is a recorded speech of a master, which has been recorded earlier, and when we are looking at the YouTube, it is not live presence of the master, it is not considered to be the same. But if you are able to watch live streaming of a talk of a master, it is possible now then to have a real darshan of a master. So that's a big change that has taken place. Modern technology enables us to have darshan of a master, even without the presence of the master, so long as the master is alive and you are seeing him alive. That makes a big difference. So today I'm going to give you this answer, that if you can see your master, and so many masters today are using this technology of being able to speak to us through live streaming on YouTube and other internet channels. So in that case, if you are looking at a master alive, that's as good as darshan of a master. So blessings can be sent by a master, even through modern technology. In the time of great master, we had to wait for a long time. There was no way to see him alive except to go to the Dera and wait in line and see him his darshan. Today technology has helped us that thousands of us can go together and see the master's face live on live streaming of a message from him. That is why I feel I am in touch with you to convey to you the blessings of great master. The blessings of great master are very powerful blessings. When I was young, I used to think he was just a master. It took me time, took me quite a while to know he was a great master, because I had a chance to see many swamis, yogis, masters, many masters, many gurus, sadgurus, satgurus. I met many. Then when I came back to great master, I could say from my own experience, he was a great master. As time has gone on, and I look back on the 84 years since I was initiated, the times have changed, and some time back you might have heard me say, he was the greatest master. Today I tell you that I have to use the phrase, he was the most greatest master. Forgive my grammar, but this is something one can use when one's feeling is so intense of the love that the great master has given. What he has given cannot be expressed even by saying most greatest master. I am deliberately making this mistake. Others have done so too. I am not the first one. When Shakespeare had to express his view, strong, intense feeling of King Lear, he said it was the most unkindest cut of all. The intensity of feeling could not be expressed with any other words. I am expressing to you the intensity of my feeling when I remember what has happened in the 84 years since I was initiated by this great master, Hazur Maharaj Baba Sawan Singh. So when you say talk of a master like that, and I have spent my whole life going around the world, meeting so many holy people, so many enlightened people, enlightened at various levels, I still would like to say, I have not found anyone like him. In India, in Punjabi, we used to say, Nairisa, Nairisa. And the translation in English would be, there is nothing to compare with him. When I first came to the United States, his song was playing here. It was out of context, but I heard the words, nothing compares to you. And I thought the Americans have already recognized the great master and his power and blessing. So that is why when we look at the actual impact of a person like Baba Sawan Singh on so many people, convey to you his blessing the same way I have been conveying to you on the 2nd of April each year. This has affected people all over the world, is affecting us. People have written to me that when there was great massacre going on in 1947 and all around the Dera, people were being killed. Great master stood by the Satsangis and so many were helped even in very dangerous circumstances. Is that true today? Yes, it is true today. The same power that helped people at that time is going to help the people today. Have faith. Faith, love and devotion is a secret. What are the teachings of a master? The teachings of a master are that you have full faith, meditate with love and devotion, and you will be taken care of by the master. That still holds true even now. And I therefore appeal to you to use this opportunity. As I said, the silver lining to everything. Imagine people used to say, we have to go to work. We have no time for meditation. Now you have all the time for meditation. You are locked down in your own homes. Meditate now as much as you can. This is a great opportunity we have got to meditate. So I'm very happy that we are now in a state when we can catch up with all the lost time we have been complaining about. We never had time to meditate. Today, you can meditate more than ever before. What does meditation with love and devotion do? It draws your attention toward the master. The more you meditate with love and devotion, the more your love and devotion grows. The more you remember your master, the more you make progress on the spiritual path. This is a path of love and devotion. I am not sure if we can all do what is required of us. It's very difficult. People cannot meditate as much as is required of us to maintain a certain level of progress, especially in these days, which we call the Iron Age, Kali Yuga. The distractions are too many for us to really fulfill our obligations as disciples of great masters. But we should do our best. And the better way is, let us surrender to the master. We have heard that if we are able to surrender to the master, our effort is enough and is complete. Satgur bhetiye puran hove jukti, phir hasdiya khadandiya prayandiya puran hove mukti. We get mukti in our daily life by doing things that we are doing normally, eating, drinking, dancing, working in our lives. So long as we have surrendered to our master, we get our salvation. So this is something very good to remember. I was playing this early morning a poem by Bulla Shah, where he says by reading too many books, you can become a Qazi. Yeah, by holding swords in your hand, you can become a Ghazi. You can go to Mecca, Medina, and come back and say you are a Haji. But what good is it? What do you get out of all this? Agar yaar nuna kiya razi, if you haven't pleased your beloved, your master. The most important thing is to please your master. The modern society has questions. Their questions, how can you treat one human being with so much respect that you surrender to that person? Isn't it a very clever way of your mind being captured by somebody else? Isn't it an exploitation? Yes, it is exploitation by many people. It's part of the whole game. It's part of the game that when one perfect living master comes, the negative power that runs this universe generates several masters around. Great master used to say, anywhere where one perfect living master has come, there are at least 11 other masters who are not perfect, and many of them are fake. This has happened throughout history. That is why it's a game going on between the negative power and the positive power, Kal and Dyal. Kal is what is running this universe. Kal literally translates to time. Time is the one that is running this universe. Time and space are creating our experiences here, and they are the trap in which we have been trapped here. Masters come outside of time and space, and they tell us how to get out. They come to take us back to our true home. We are very lucky if we are picked up by a master, because it will mean that we are ready as souls to go back to our true home. It's wonderful to know that the master, when he initiates us, gives us a guarantee that we will be back to our true home, which is beyond time and space, beyond Brahm and Parabrahm, and with the true home, our Sachkhand, that is where masters take us. Not only do they say that we will take you there, they give us the means to verify the doubting mind that this can actually happen. They enable us, while we are sitting here in this physical body, to verify and validate what the masters are saying is true or not. That is why meditation is a means of validation. Meditation is not a means of going anywhere. It is only for our mind to validate and confirm that the master, what he said, is true, and we can see it. Otherwise, the master's word, when he gives us that you will be taken back home, is a guarantee. You don't believe in the guarantee? Go and check it out. So that's what the masters tell us. Masters don't come here to convert us to something else. They don't come here to establish religions. Religions have been established after masters have gone. They don't establish any societies, any religions or anything. They come for the whole world and pick up those who are marked souls. Those who are marked for them to take home, they take them home in their own lifetime. So very often, many people meet these masters who are not on the list of their marked souls, but just by having the darshan of these masters, they get a big benefit. They get marked. They get marked by other masters to take them home later on, maybe in the next few lives. So therefore, it's a very great thing to be able to have a darshan of a master. According to Sri Guru Granth Sahib, if you have had a darshan of a master, your account is over. In Sadhguru darshan ditha, tiska lekha nibhya. The account is finished at that time, because our account is going on in this physical world for thousands of years, millions of years, several lifetimes. And that account gets finished by one darshan of a master. There is no greater power than having the darshan of a master. It has to be a living master. A master who is gone cannot give us the same benefit. There is a story about Sheikh Farid of Shakarkanji. Shakarkanji Farid was telling his son, "Son, my master Sheikh Qutbuddin is getting old and he may pass away. The body we have to leave. All masters have left their bodies." So Farid was trying to tell his son, please get initiated, get the diksha, get the proper initiation from Sheikh Qutbuddin. And the son, like many sons today, said, I am a young guy, I have still to love many years, so dad, I will think about it when I am older. One day, Sheikh Qutbuddin died. The son ran to Sheikh Qutbuddin, whose body was lying there, and he got his head shaved, which was the practice in those days, and he put his head on the feet of the dead body of the master, Qutbuddin. Farid was standing there, and he said, son, this is the body of one for whom I have had the highest respect, highest love. Nobody has had greater impact on me than Qutbuddin, whose body lies here. But sorry, you missed the time. Even 1 second is too late. You should have taken advantage when Qutbuddin was alive. This is just a piece of flesh. Master has left. He is not in this body anymore. This is a very important thing. You have to have a living master. Only living master who has everything in his body at that time, who has the highest awareness, totality of awareness in his body, working from his body, such a master gives us what we are looking for. So that is why he said, I'm sorry, son, you did not get what you wanted. But because Farid was then named by Qutbuddin to be his successor, later the son got initiated from his own father. These are nice stories. We hear many other cases like that. A living master is a necessity. People come to me, they say that we have been initiated by great master Baba Sawan Singh in our dreams, in our meditation. We never met him, but we have been initiated by him. So when I check with my master, I find they got darshan and therefore they are waiting for initiation, but they were not initiated by great master. A perfect living master has to initiate them now. Therefore, they have to come back to a perfect living master to get initiation. The fact that they got a darshan of the great master in a previous life guarantees that they will get initiation, but not by a dead master. We are looking to dead masters more than to living masters. We have more doubt on a living person being a master and less doubt about people who have died. It is very strange that a dead master who cannot tell you anything because he is dead, we are quoting him what he said to other people at some time, and that has more value for us than a person who is alive and can tell us, no, that is not what you are thinking. Dead master don't say no. Only living master can say no if we go wrong on anything. So that is why it's very important to remember that the whole spiritual teachings of Sant Mat is based upon teaching of a perfect living master, not a dead master. Now you might say, I am celebrating this Bhandara of Baba Sawan Singh. He is dead. His body is gone. He died on 2nd of April, 1948. How am I telling you all this, conveying his blessings to you? How am I conveying the blessings of a dead master? Am I not contradicting myself? Not really. When I speak to you, I am speaking because for me, Baba Sawan Singh is not dead. That's the beauty of being initiated by a perfect living master who is alive. When he's alive, if he initiates you, he stays alive within you forever. That's the beauty of initiation by a perfect living master. When he initiates you, he does not die for you. When my master was very old, I remember I had a meeting with him, and I said, Master, people are worried. You are old. You will go away. What will they do? He said, don't worry. Initiation is a guarantee that the master will never die. How does that happen? He said, the real master who initiates you is not the person outside. The real master sits inside. And when he initiates you, he manifests himself inside. When a perfect living master passes away in his physical body, his inner form, his radiant form, his Nuri Sroop, becomes more alive than you ever known before. That is my experience. For me, great master never died. He is as alive today as he was alive when he was physically present with us. That is why, excuse me, that is why when I say to you, I am conveying to you the blessings of great master Baba Sawan Singh, I am not saying I am remembering an old man with a white beard who gave the darshan long ago. I am talking of somebody who is giving darshan right now, at this moment. Right now, who is present with me, right now. As clear as he was when he was in his physical body. Therefore, it's a very different thing. If you are initiated by a perfect living master, you will find that he will never leave you. Just do one small thing, just to satisfy your mind. Do enough meditation to go up to this third eye center behind your eyes and check out, is he there or not? Just have a little tip inside your own self, not outside, inside your own self to verify, is he there? And if you find him there, you'll find he is the same person, same being, same powerful person, the one who expressed himself as a physical body when he was alive physically, but inside he is going to be with you forever. Not for a short time, not for your current life. He'll be there even when you die, he'll still be there. This relationship of a disciple and a perfect living master goes on forever. So that is why today, when I am talking to you, I am conveying to you the blessings of a great master who is alive for me, and therefore his blessings are alive for me, and I can convey them to you. Do your duty according to what is needed in this physical world. Here we have this coronavirus, and this is going to create some problems, and people have a painful experience, some have emotional painful experience, some have got actual physical experiences which are not too pleasant. You have to put up with these things because this life, this world is made up of ups and downs. Pain and pleasure go together. One of the early instructions I got from a master to stay as a good disciple of him was, and I quote in Punjabi or Hindi, Dukh sukh dono sam kar jano aur maan apmana. You must take dukkh and sukh, pain and pleasure, equally. And you must take somebody praising you or insulting you equally. That's the necessary requirement if you want to be a disciple of a perfect living master. That is how we live in this world. The world is like a show, a drama. Both things will happen and you accept both equally. That is why it is my appeal to you that when you are feeling low, well, accept it. That's a period of feeling low. When you feel high, accept it as feeling high. Life is made up of that. And therefore, follow the instructions which are being given by the state government, given by different countries, that you stay indoors. That's a time to stay indoors and meditate more. These things will also pass. There is no event, either high or low, which has lasted forever. Even this coronavirus problem that's going on will pass. And therefore, it's a matter of having some patience. Use it usefully in meditating, taking care of yourself, and taking care of things that you could not take care of. Many people say, oh, we had so many books in the house, we never got time to read. Read them now. Oh, we could not sort out our house, things were all lying in a clutter. Organize them now. It's a good time to take care of so many things which you could not do earlier. There's always a bright side of everything that happens in life. Take advantage of it. I would urge you to follow the instructions being given to overcome this problem that we are facing now. And therefore, do not be show bravado that because we have a master, therefore we should not follow it. We are supposed to be living in a world where we live according to the rules of the world. Therefore, we should follow the instructions that are given. They are good instructions. As I have understood it, this coronavirus is not the first coronavirus. They have been before. But this is a novel coronavirus. The novelty of this coronavirus is that it is not carried by air, it's carried by droplets and sticks on a surface and can last a long time. That is why use sanitizers, use all kinds of things that are available. Any sanitizer with 60% or more of alcohol destroys it. Even they say that heat and humidity can take care of it. I read a report from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT. They say that the temperature and humidity will affect this. There are many other things that are happening around us which will take care of this. Just have patience and don't worry too much about it. This is an opportunity given to us to meditate more. When I remember several ups and downs that have happened in my life, the last 93 years and plus, I see how well balanced they were. That you could go high and low in worldly circumstances. One can be rich and poor, one can be sick and healthy. All those things I experienced. And it's nice to look back and realize that life is made up like that. It is not all goody-goody stuff, nor all terrible stuff. If it was all good, and we were all in good karma, and had done all good things in the past, we wouldn't be here. We would be in heaven. We would be sitting in an astral plane, in a Vaikunth, in a Bahisht. We had great places to go to if all our karma was so great. If all our karma was bad, and we are evil people, we wouldn't be here either. We would be in hell. Again, in a very terrible place located in the sub-astral area, which is called hell. So therefore, we are here because our karma was a combination of good and bad. And we still have a karma that is good and bad. And therefore, physical life is a mixture of both. I remember my old friend, Dr. Julia Johnson, who came from the United States as a preacher for Christianity. And he wanted to convert people to the Christian faith. That was what he came for, to India. But some satsangis, American satsangis, had told him, if you are in India, you must go and meet the great master Baba Sawan Singh. He said, I will see this holy man that you are talking of, but I don't know if he will be helpful to me. He had that exchange of letters with the friends who were in the United States. Julian Johnson was posted by his church to work in Calcutta area in India. While he was in Calcutta, he decided to make a special visit to the Dera to see Great Master. And he wrote to Great Master that I'll be coming to the Dera to see you and please give me a time when I can see you. Great Master's secretary wrote to him that you are most welcome. Come by a fast train. That time there were not too many planes running. So come by a fast train, come straight from Calcutta. But it does not stop at the station Bias, where the Dera is located. So you can get down either at Jalandhar, which comes half an hour earlier, or at Amritsar, which comes half an hour later, and somebody will pick you up from there and bring you to the Dera to meet the master. Also, it was suggested, if you stop at Jalandhar, which comes first, there's an attorney living right next to the railroad station, and he'll be able to pick you up. His name is Bhagat Singh. He will be able to recognize you easily, because not too many foreigners or white persons travel by these trains. On the other hand, what happened? At the Dera, Great Master told Bhagat Singh, this American is coming, he's specially coming to see me, let's give him a surprise. He said, he will be coming very tired from his long journey, and when he arrives at Jalandhar, tell him, Dr. Johnson, before we go to Dera, let's go home, my house is just next to the station, let's go home and have a cup of tea. And he will say, no, I have not come for tea, I want to meet the great master as soon as I can. And you insist to take him home, he'll get very, very irritated with you. But as he's irritated, bring him to your house. And great master said, I will be sitting hiding there in your house. Many people, when they hear this story, can't think of masters playing tricks like that. But it was a very good trick that he played, because when Judy and Johnson came and met Bhagat Singh at the station, the same thing happened. Bhagat Singh insisted that Judy and Johnson should go to his house for a cup of tea, and Judy and Johnson got irritated. I have to go to see the master. I have not come for tea. But he just took him home, and then he said, Dr. Judy and Johnson, I have a surprise for you. He took him to his living room, and great master was sitting there. The surprise was indeed so great that Judy and Johnson could not say any words. He said, Master, you come all the way to see me? And great master said, I have only come 25 miles to see you. You have come several thousand miles to come to me. Then Julian Johnson wrote a letter that same night to his friends in America, which I had a chance to see the copy of it, in which he said, I have spent just a couple of hours with this great master, and we have not exchanged many words, but what I got is all I needed. If I get nothing more in my life, I'll be satisfied that I got what I came for. That's the very first meeting of Judy and Johnson. Judy and Johnson spoke English and did not speak any Indian language. I was a student of college, not school student at that time, very young, but I could speak English. So I became a little bit of a friend, a young friend of Judy and Johnson. I remember we used to go for walks to the river Bias almost daily when I was at the Dera, and he would talk to me about his experiences in America, and I would tell him my experience with the great master in India, and we used to share many experiences. One day he told me that he has been asking great master for favors to be done to his friends in America. Somebody is sick, master, please take care of him. Somebody is having other problems, accidents or something, please take care of him. One day he told me, what am I doing? I am interfering in the karma of these people who I understand should have both high and low. Why am I interfering? I have not realized till now that life is a package given to us with high and low. If it wasn't a package like that, we wouldn't be a human being. We would never have a chance to meet a master. And he said, Julian Johnson said, from that day, he said, I will make no recommendation to great master or anybody now. Everybody lives according to their karma. It's a big blessing that they have come to know great master. It's a big blessing that I can convey the blessings of a living master to my friends at home. So there is a big change. We have to understand life is made up of high and low, and that is why it is important to accept both high and low. I am not surprised that so many of you are now accepting the highs and lows. You come to me, you tell me your life stories, they are all full of the same highs and lows. Nobody lives here with only all highs and all lows. But one thing I can tell you, if you have love and devotion for your master, if you have faith in the master, he'll take care of everything. Not only your meditation, he'll take care of your life. That again I'm telling you from my personal experience and experience of several others. If you are willing to depend entirely with love and devotion and faith in your master, he will take care of everything. So that is why, that's the secret. To have love and devotion, do enough meditation to develop your faith. I am very happy that I am able to talk to you on this day of Bhandara. I send you the blessings of great master. I know I would have given you some prasad also. Now the prasad has to be also given. Just by picture. Here is a picture. Open the prasad you already have with you. Get some more, buy some more, remember this picture and take the prasad, remembering great master. Great master blessings on all of you. I'm very happy we could celebrate this Bhandara together. And what we could not do was give great master initiations, which I hope will be possible sometime in the meditation workshop in September or another meeting we can have specially. Thank you very much for listening to me, and great master blessings on all of you.